Breaking from our headline story tonight, here is more news from around the Middle East, Far East, and even further east. Snow flurries around the Macedonia metro area have left Roman road patrol picking up after a 24-chariot pileup. The emperor's chief fashion designer was beheaded tonight after a new design left him feeling all too exposed. Could your sacrifice be doing more bad than good? Recent studies have shown that this and other actions could be contributing to an escalated increase in the Earth's temperature. This is what some wise men have termed global warming. Olive oil prices continue to drop, leaving many growers wondering if they will have enough money to have a crop next year. The Saudi king, the world's largest producer of olive oil, is calling for a halt in production. In business, the Dow Jones Industrial Average closed at a record high for the first time ever, closing above 10 points. If you are just joining us, we are live in Bethlehem tonight, uncovering some breaking news. This really could be one of the biggest news stories of the year. We are actually getting word from our affiliate at Herod's Palace that a traveling caravan of some sort may be connected to our story. Let's go to our reporter out in the field for more details.
Yes, we're here live at Herod's Palace. He is going to make some sort of announcement. We're getting word that it's going to be affecting a lot of families. He is about to make this this statute, and it's very... Okay, we're getting a report that it is about to happen now. We're going to send it over, and they're going to go straight to it live.
I, King Herod the Great, address my subjects today on a matter of utmost importance. I was recently informed of a child being born in Judea, in the area of Bethlehem, whose family is claiming that the child is king of the Jews. Must I remind you that Herod the Great is the only king of the Jews? Is it not Herod that rebuilt your temple? Have I not given you wealth and stability in all my years of rule? I am not a king to be trifled with. I will be king over the body of this child, rumored to be born in Bethlehem, and called King of the Jews. Magi from the east visited me at the palace yesterday, saying, "Where is he who is born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him. I am the only king to be worshipped. I met with the chief priests and the scribes. I asked them where would the Christ, the supposed Messiah of the people, be born. They said, the prophet Micah said, in Bethlehem of Judea. And you, Bethlehem, land of Judea, are by no means least among the leaders of Judah. For out of you shall come forth a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel. Be assured, this king, your only true king, secretly called the Magi, and cleverly requested when the star first appeared to them. I smiled and said, go to Bethlehem, make a careful search for the child, and when you have found him, report to me, that I may too come and worship him. I'm certainly they did not suspect a thing. I eagerly await their return. Worship him? He will worship me. I watched the wise men climb aboard their dusty camels and head for Bethlehem. If there is such a child, I want to know it. I want to know it today. Good citizens, obedient citizens, citizens who want to live, I call upon you to communicate all information to me personally. I am sending a legion of soldiers to Bethlehem this very day. Their orders are to reach out, search out every male child under the age of 2 years. These wise men, these magi, had better not trick me. I am enraged. If you want to hear weeping, you will hear weeping in Ramah, and a great mourning for children who dare threaten the throne of King Herod the Great. Long live the king! Long live King Herod!
We are back in the HLNN studio. If you're just tuned in, King Herod the Great has addressed the nation about these strangers called Magi who have upset him. He is enraged by the thought that anyone who would attempt to overthrow his rule. If you see anything unusual, please contact one of HLNN's field reporters. Do not, under any circumstances, take the king's word lightly. We cannot, in any good conscience, call upon you to communicate in any way with the current king. To do so may mean the end of young lives in our land. If you are living in the vicinity of Bethlehem, we urge you to protect your children. We bring a brief intermission with a word from our sponsor.